standing in front of the congregation at St. Patrick Catholic Church.
Lord be with you.
Deacon Greg Gitcher has always felt the call to serve.
You become a part of really important things in people's lives. You know, I'm there for the baptism of the child. I'm there for when they make First Communion. I'm there for confirmation. I can be there for when they get married.
Gospel of the Lord.
And I can be there when they pass away in the funeral.
That call to service wasn't always clear.
Going down my journey this way, I was 50 years old. I never planned on wearing a collar.
But something.
Oh, I got it. Hey, I got in the White House.
Nudged him to the church, flipping his life upside down. Now he serves a higher power.
It's a different kind of service, you know. Yeah, I used to like drive around in a red Porsche with a girl and a machine gun hanging out of the roof and the KGB chasing me in limos. That's pretty much every night.
After 21 years in the Secret Service.
Used to be saving people's butts, and now I'm saving their souls. Everybody knows us as bodyguards, or as the Navy SEALs call us, bullet catchers.
Gitcher's career began as an LMPD officer before becoming a Secret Service agent. His first assignment, guarding the 39th President of the United States.
Right out of the box, I picked up President Jimmy Carter in Lexington and drove him to the Kentucky Derby. I mean, it's pretty amazing to think you're walking into the White House, you know.
He went on to serve several other presidents, including Ronald Reagan, who gave him a nickname.
From that point on, I was always Kentucky. Being a Louisville fan, that kind of hurt my heart, but he would call me Kentucky.
Gitcher spent years traveling the world protecting celebrities, CEOs, politicians, and royalty. But it was one of his last assignments that made the biggest impact on his life. Protecting Pope John Paul II.
I don't know how I got selected, because hundreds and hundreds of Secret Service agents want to be one of the close escorts of the Pope.
One of just six agents on the side of His Holiness, Gitcher escorted the pontiff during his 1999 visit to St. Louis.
I just felt like I was the luckiest guy. I felt like I hit the lottery.
20 years ago.
117,000 people up in St. Louis. Bringing him in there with all those people going just crazy.
Yet Gitcher remembers it like it was yesterday.
I mean, I remember people holding babies over the railings just to be close to the Pope mobile as he drove by. So we got three, to Carol, Mary, and Dot. Okay.
A faithful encounter that led him to this latest chapter.
Is it to your whole family, or do you?
All of a sudden, I take this crazy turn and go to school for 5 years.
Gitcher's finally telling his story in a new book, Sneakin' Deacon, From Secret Service to Sacred Service.
I've been telling war stories forever, and people keep saying, hey, tell us that story about this, or tell us a story about that.
How many books are you?
This year? Six books. So Brian Stanford, he put up with me and all my war stories and put into a great book.
Each page a reflection on the divine journey of servitude that eventually led him to the altar.
I'm just grateful for everything that I have, and I'm thinking this is a way I can give something back.
Kate Springer, WDRB News.